Last time on Babs Bear Talk.
Hi. Did Michael count?
That is true. I was doing my hair today, and I'm like, one always has to look good if the other looks bad.
I'm getting ready to do a show, but my God, this is a lot of getting ready today because I have to do my nails.
Ooh. And my bad. My guitar almost fell.
Your guitar almost fell. I have to do my nails, and then I have to clean the stove. It's like everybody cooks on the stove, but nobody cleans it. I know you clean it from time to time, but Daddy never cleans it.
That's why I make sandwiches.
And then I have to put away all the stuff. And even though some of those things don't get seen on camera, it makes me feel out of sorts. Huh? No. You go in your
bed. You're sick.
I go in my bed.
You're sick. This is what a gambling addiction looks like.
You guys. He doesn't want to go buy the lemons 3 for $1 because he's waiting for this dude to sell him 15 for $1. So he's over there dying, and then he does this. He coughs over everything and everyone. We run. He's like the worst patient ever.
Ever.
And I was like, oh my God.
He like wipes. See, look at him. He's wiping his nose. He's not even covering his mouth.
Yeah, then he.
And he like wipes it on everything.
All of a sudden he wants to love everybody.
Yeah.
Like that drunk uncle that you want to.
No.
Don't
come near me. Cleanse
him. Hurt me then.
No, look at him.
Now you're so fresh. You're so fresh.
Joe should know by now that you don't play chicken with me.
Exactly.
You play chicken with Barbara. I am not turning away. You know what chicken is, right, Jay?
Chickens when you're out with the cars, and yeah, when if one doesn't, you know.
If one doesn't turn out, they say mathematically one will always turn out. One's not gonna be me.
It's not gonna be me.
I'm coming full barrel ahead because
we gonna die
stubborn.
Today.
I'm stubborn.
Oh, is that where I get it from? I thought I got stubbornness from him.
So it's a good day today because I don't have to worry about checking in on my dad. My sister got that handled. You got that, sis.
Look at mom's Coolio hair because she has to curl her hair.
Oh God, I forgot I had it in.
Your
like
Coolio.
You know
hair.
What? My makeup on fleek, so I don't care how my hair looks like. Just get this out of the way. We did fried jacks this morning, and you guys, he's sick, but he still wants fancy breakfast like bacon and fried jack. I'm like, are you really sick though?
I didn't even get that. They treat me so bad when I'm sick, guys.
He went from like, I have an itchy throat when he came out from the auction, straight up to, I've got TB. I was like, good Lord.
Well, I'm going to go before I get sick.
Yeah, she's going to go record at Colin, and I'm going to be redoing.
Hence my guitar, the banana, my phone, and my book.
Oh, let me show them what I'm going to be doing.
Okay.
I'm going to be redoing, where's my stuff at? Okay, the Billy's and Me pie. One, you know, a couple of reasons. One, the old video is old and long. I want to make it shorter. And two, somebody told me that if I lay the dough over here for the meat pie, right? And I take this one and I do this, boom. When I do this, I just have to cut away and then do it for this one. I don't know if it's gonna work. So you may or may not see this video on Monday. Because if it doesn't work, I have no reason to redo the meat pie. So you may not see it, okay?
Okay. All right.
Be careful going over there, Jada.
Okay, bye.
Those idiots. Look, guys. My little stand broke today, and my camera almost fell off of it. Thank God I followed my instincts, or the Holy Ghost. And when I was gonna walk away, I felt something, and I didn't walk away, and I saw it toppling, and I was able to grab it. Because with the new camera opening upwards, the door opening upwards, it gets a little bit top heavy. So I went out and bought one for $15 today at Walmart. It's a little bit taller and sturdier than this, but this has served me well for 4 years. So my meat patties. I did one meat patty. My meat pies came out really, really lovely today. And I can't wait to go edit that video right now. And Joshua and I went to Walmart and we were doing a side-by-side comparison of the two cameras on the Zoom. So we stood like at a certain location. We zoomed into the front door of Walmart. Joshua did an excellent job running his camera. And I obviously didn't do anything because I don't even see the clip on my camera. So I don't think I hit the record button at all. I'm thinking it's because on the new camera they switched up where the record button is. And I'm thinking I went by just finger memory and press play instead of record. I still don't know what happened. We're going to have to go redo that tomorrow. But I'm working on a review on these two cameras to put up at the review channel. So Joe is doing a lot better today, but only because I went out and got him NyQuil. He was doing all these home remedies and that cough sounded like bronchitis or TB or something, I'm like, oh God, no. Joe is like the worst patient. He's really good at taking care of you when you're sick, but when he's sick, he's the worst patient. So the NyQuil made him sleep. He looks and he sounds a lot better right now. If that cough still sounds, you know, in his chest here, we'll see if we'll take him in tomorrow to, I guess that's urgent care, to see if he needs antibiotics because it could be bronchitis. You know, I'm teasing about it sounding like bronchitis, but it could be. So who are you guys rooting for with this Super Bowl thing? I never root for anybody because I never even know who's playing. I don't watch the halftime. I don't watch any of the thing to do with the Super Bowl more than if somebody invites me to a party, I'll eat. You know? So, but I'm rooting for the Falcons. Let me tell you why. And why I even happen to know that the Falcons is competing in this thing. It's because the other team, the owner, the coach, and one of the team members are all Donald Trump's lackeys. So it's like, no, they need to lose, and they need to lose huge. Huge, right? Huge. So or bigly. They need to lose bigly. That man's an idiot. When I saw the thing on Facebook saying that he went on vacation already, I thought it was fake news. He's actually on vacation already. Like Joshua said, he just let loose of a bunch of grenades and just go, okay, bye. You guys clean it up. I'm going down to vacation. We all know that it's President Bannon that's running the show, right? We all know that, right? Because we're not dumb. He's not running things. Pence is not running things. He's praying hard to get that guy on the Supreme Court so that when all these cases, these lawsuits that are coming against him and his administration gets up to that level, he can win. And I'm hoping that doesn't happen. I'm hoping that because Harry Reid changed the thing back in 2013 to make it be a simple majority to put through these federal agents, that I'm hoping that doesn't come back to bite us in the butt, because they can now turn around and try to do the same thing, even though for Supreme Court nominees, I think it has to be 60, but they can change the rules. It seems like they can change the rules anytime they want to change the rules, right? But I guess Harry Reid must have foresaw that if I do this, they can screw us in the future, but if I don't do this, they will still screw us because we're not going to get anybody in. So since 2013 to 2016, President Obama put in 89 federal judges. And thank God for that, because they have sense. And they're working with these lawsuits. And thank God for the one that Bush put in, the one in Seattle, Washington, that put the restraining order against the ban. Yes, yes. You know, I really feel like this is a fight between good and evil. And people are not seeing it that way. They're like, oh, we just have different political views. No, we don't. It's not about political views. It's about this man is evil and destructive and hateful and petty and mean and dishonorable and unfaithful in everything that he does, and they want him in. The only thing this man was truthful about is that he was going to go in and do what he said he was going to do, decimate everything. So anyways, let me go check on Joel, start editing, and I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Sunday for Super Bowl day, and we're in Costco. There's Jory in the line. Here's the recovered. You feeling better, babe?
A little better.
A little bit better? You look a little bit better.
My lower back hurt. I'm alright.
Your lower back hurt? That means the virus is leaving you.
See Costco's hole? See that lady? Her gas tank is on the left. And the hose goes all the way to suit her car. That's what I like about putting in gas at Costco.
I imagine that.
Came to Costco to pick up something special for something special that's gonna happen soon.
It's drugs.
Did I tease you guys enough? I'm teasing, huh, babe? That's what they do on the news. They tease a story and they tease that story, and you're waiting to see it, and it will always come on at 25 minutes after the hour. So if the news starts at 11 at night and they're teasing some story you want to see, you best believe it's going to come at 25 after the hour. Unless it's something to do with the idiot that's in office. Ooh, they bring that right away as headline. I'm like, and that's when I go click. Me and Sandra. Sandra, right? I keep the remote close because the minute he comes on or they say anything about him, click! We go to another channel. So Jory's with me because he came to change his Costco card, because you know we're switching over to the other business. Why is Joshua not with us? He's asleep. So So he's gonna have to come another day when we come in the evening time. Today for dinner, we're just gonna do nachos. I bought some organic tortilla chips because they were cheap. And we're gonna do the nacho cheese. I'm gonna make ground beef. I'm gonna do some kind of salsa. We have the avocado salsa. I can't do that though. The MSG is getting to me, but Jada will do that. What else do we have to put on the nacho, Jory? I don't have no avocado. Well, you on this damn drugs. Joe, he's gonna hit us.
No, okay. He's good. My truck drivers don't drive bad. True story, bro. Have I been in an accident ever? No.
Guys who drive trucks don't drive bad, according to Jory.
So it's 7:45, and this is what I'm watching. The pastor at the church is anointing all the leaders with oil. There was an email sent out in the middle of the week by the secretary to the pastor saying that he wanted all the leaders in the church to show up today for 6 o'clock service, and he would bless them with oil. I can only imagine that maybe attendance is low right now, especially for the 6 o'clock service, and I don't think he would get a lot of people in today. I mean, regular people that are not leaders in the church, because it's Super Bowl Sunday. You know, you guys know I'm not into sports, right? I was only rooting for the Falcons because that stupid you-know-who was rooting for that cheating Tom Brady. You know, Deflategate? That dude. So, anyways, I'm not into sports. My dad was a sports person when I was growing up. He was a cyclist. He was so good that he even represented Belize in the Olympics in 1968 when it was held in Mexico. He didn't win anything, but he represented. So, the way I understand the Olympics, it's kind of like Grammys and Emmys and Oscars and stuff. It's an honor just to even be nominated. That follows you the rest of your life. The nominate, blah, 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 Grammy nominee, you know, that follows you, or Grammy winner, whatever, it follows you, right? So none of my dad's kids got into sports. None of my dad's grandkids got into sports. And all because of mommy. Mommy put all of us in the arts. I've been recording Saturday and Sunday, as you guys can see earlier in the vlog. I just didn't upload anything last night because every now and again I have to take one day off. And I told you guys if it's not Saturday, it'll be Sunday. So nothing much was happening yesterday. I was taking care of Joe, and then I did the video for the meat pies, which came out good, by the way. I just got through editing it, and the trick that the subscriber taught me worked. So I was really, really excited. So then today, Joe and Jory and I went to Costco, and Jory successfully changed the card into the right business name. And then when we were doing the card change, the girl that was taking care of us, she started to cough, such a really bad cough. It's not the kind that Joe has that sounds, you know, it sounded like asthma. To me, it sounded like asthma. And so I asked her if she was asthmatic, and she said, yeah, some fragrance or something must have hit her because she was really having like an attack with allergies and asthma and everything. And I told her that it was Jory, because Jory wears some type of body lotion that I can't stand the smell. I told me it smells like a Persian man. I was like, oh my God, stop wearing that thing. It makes me sick to my stomach. And I told her it was him, but he got all mad at me. And then we left her and went and shopped and everything. And on the way back out, she was normal and she was taking care of customers. And I told Jory, see, it's you. That customer is in front of her and she's not choking to death. It's you. So he's all mad and he goes, you don't like anything that I buy to wear. I'm like, because everything you buy is gross. It's too overpowering. Mommy, so, huh?
Tell your husband to stop using the paper towel to wipe your hand to blow his nose, because every 5 minutes he's getting a paper towel and wasting your paper towel. And then every 5 minutes he's trying to sicken your camera boy and sicken your golden goose. Yeah. Coming over here and trying to cough and sneeze on us. Yeah. And we keep telling him to stop. And he's like, oh, just remember, I'm your father and you don't love me. I told him, it's okay, I'll be in love my whole life. It's cool.
Why does he want to love us now that he's sick?
He's so sick. And we keep telling him to pee and go to his bed, and he just keeps touching everything.
Pee and go to your bed.
With his gawk. It's like
he got that from my aunt Nita's husband, Philip. Pee and go to your bed.
It's like he has Spanish influenza and he wants the whole house to die with him. I'm trying not to get a sore throat. I was sitting there.
He sneezed on you?
Yeah. I was sitting there waiting with Joshua while he cleaned, and he comes right behind me instead of staying on the couch, and he sneezes, and I get up and I grab the thing of honey.
Joshua, all I see is white teeth.
The darkness.
Hey.
And that stuff from the kitchen is going to rough up his nose. He's going to have
I told him too. That. And he's wasting it. Yeah. He's wasting it. What are we gonna put on the plate to put bacon on?
Right?
Not that anymore because it has his disease.
I'm still going to eat my bacon.
Yeah. No, he touched it.
I could do camera set.
He touched it.
I like bacon.
No, I put my bacon on the egg thing. I cook my bacon on the egg thing.
The egg
thing? What do you mean? The egg crate. We have a stash back there, like those paper plates.
Oh, in
the
laundry. A bunch of those on.
That's what I cook it on. That's what he taught me.
The thing's big.
It is.
No, we only put 4 pieces on it. You throw it away when you're done.
I only do 2. That's kind of a waste.
Yeah. That's what we saved it for. We'll cut the egg thing.
That's work.
Tear it.
I gotta wake up and do
paper
stuff.
Paper towel is meant for the kitchen.
Can I have some?
What? I don't know. That's what it does.
What's up with that?
I don't know. That's what it does. Hmm. The next camera had a big.
Yeah, there's just bars on the bottom and top. Okay. Yeah, just bars on the bottom and top.
When it records, see?
Yeah.
Uh huh.
That's annoying.
We lose everything on this
there's,
one.
There's probably there a to setting.
A setting.
That's probably like super widescreen.
Like you'll help me when I'm done.
Maybe.
Josh. So no, they're behind me. After all that screaming off camera.
Well, we can't go out there because it's infected. We have to Lysol it.
Well, does he have Spanish influenza?
He does.
It's ground zero and daddy's subject zero.
He is.
Jada, when are you going to do your movie thing? Do one now for the ending of my vlog. Oh my God, did you guys hear him? Did you hear him?
See why we're in here?
Okay, Jada, do one of the movies for my thing. Do Django.
No, it's too long.
Django's too long? Do pick
Josh
one.
Okay, so this little girl that like looks like a little girl, but I guess she's not like a little girl, decides to like end up in an orphanage because she's into like 30-year-old dudes, right? And so then like Thaisa Farmiga's sister was all like, "Well, we lost a baby. I have a deaf child, and my other kid's kind of a little psychopath, but not a psychopath. Why don't we go adopt a kid?" But instead of picking one of those kids, they're all like laughing and playing. They decide to go pick the weird one who's drawing.
Not drawing.
Painting.
Like a real painting.
Instead of she's down there playing with the other kids, that's a big red flag. And they're like, "Oh, let's adopt her." They adopt her, and then some stuff starts happening. And she starts messing with the deaf kid, and so magically she knows sign language within 2 days. And then the little boy's outside playing with a BB gun, kills a bird by accident, but the bird's not fully dead. So the orphan chick's like, "Oh, we gotta kill it." She just picks up a rock and smushes the bird. And they're like, "I guess we're still gonna keep her." And then,
screw that.
The minute they start killing animals, that's it.
Like,
bye.
Effective. Take it back.
Sociopath.
They hit up the black nun that was like, "Yeah, take her, whatever. We got no record of her, but whatever." And so the black nun's like, "I came to visit." And then she's like, walking, because I'm a nun and don't have a car. Oh, wait, she does have a car, but her car broke down. And then all of a sudden, little orphan girl comes and kills black nun like she killed the bird. And you're like, "Damn, black nun, like that. And then Thaisa Farmiga goes crazy. Well, her sister.
Who's Thaisa Farmiga?
The main chick. The mother.
Okay.
This is basically the same person. goes crazy. They send her to the hospital. "Daddy, I'm doing something. Go away. You're sad."
She's
go
in the middle
home.
Of something. One
go
second.
Home.
1 second. She's in the middle of something with the blog. Go ahead.
So
remember what
they,
you want to tell me, though.
They send her away. And so then the creepy little orphan's like, "This is my best chance to try to get the dad." And so then like she's all dressed up and like cocktails and trying to wine and dine the dad. And the dad's like, "What are you doing? You're a kid. What the hell? I ain't no pedo." And then she kills the dad because the dad don't want her. And then the mom comes back and was like, looking at the dead body of the dad, was like, "I told you she was crazy." And then
I told you.
Then they have this hot battle on the icy lake. Orphan falls through the hole, and then the mom comes out of the hole and is like, "I won, I'm coming out." And the orphan grabs her foot and is like, "Mama, no." And then she's like, "Oh, I'm not your mom." And then boom, hits her in the jaw. She's dead, snaps her neck. End of the story. The dad dies. You don't care because he was stupid.
That's orphan.
She's at home.
What do you give it out of 10, Jenna? What do you give it out of 10?
7 out of 10. Oh my God.
It was okay.
I hope you guys heard all of that. She's going to be doing some of those as we go along. Oh my God. Joel, what were you doing? What were you going to tell me? Can you go on the vlog? Some guy on Facebook?
From Facebook. This is the man get up and have to tell traffic before so much people.
Oh, that's that man's dad. That happened in the campaign.
His son was killed. His son's a hero, like a Purple Heart hero.
Was that the only one that got that country get out of the country in Montana and American citizens?
Yeah. I think white people think they have control of this, but they don't realize there are more of us than there are of them.
Me and Rachel were talking. She's like, I couldn't watch the Super Bowl because I saw Mike Pence, and I was like, nah. And I was like, was it just me, or did Mike Pence look like Darth Maul?
Joe, look who come back to church again. Look, she come back forever. Thank God we're not going to know. I can't take she.
And
she can't sing for nothing.
She can't sing for being.
Okay, what were you saying? Something about the Kim Kardashian thing. Tell me the bean.
Yeah, and it's like, y'all giving Kim crap when she did this, calling her a hoe. And it's like, y'all figured than Beyonce when she was carrying glue in her womb.
Y'all know Beyonce didn't carry that first baby, right? It is her baby. Obviously. But she didn't carry that baby, though. And I don't know why she's ashamed of that, because I would give her mad respect if she would just come on out and say, I used, you know, a surrogate. I'd like her more. Because I don't dislike Beyonce. I like her songs. I like Beyonce. I'm not crazy about Beyonce like some other people now. But,
yeah.
I don't know why they have to put... Why did she have to put that veil and... People crazy. Anyways, guys.
She did it underwater. Everybody's like, okay, Beyonce, you're getting a little too crazy.
That was underwater?
There's more.
Oh, I only saw the one with the green veil. I don't see the rest of that mess.
More memes because there's another one with her in blue. Uh-huh. She's like on a...
She named her baby Blue.
Blue Ivy.
I remember now.
And she's like, Beyonce's laying on a chair and Blue Ivy comes and gives her like a rose. Uh-huh. And the meme is like, when your mom calls you to give her something that's right next to her. And I'm like, oh my God.
Remote. I'll see you tomorrow night, guys. I've got to get this video up for you guys. Bye, Z.
Bye.
Bye.
When the red button is on?
Yeah.
Okay,
guys, see, I'm doing it.
This is very
ready. He doesn't want to go back on the boat.
Splash.
Splash?
Yeah.